In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A very warm welcome to St. Lawrence's this morning. Whether you're watching at home or elsewhere, welcome to your church this morning. Our Mass this morning proceeds in the usual manner. If you want a copy of the readings, you can download them from the parish website, stlawrencecathedral.org.uk. There's a link there on the home page. I do hope that you'll enjoy this Mass, especially as for the first time for a year we are singing hymns in church. It's very sad that we can't sing them together, but I do hope that wherever you are, you will join in with the hymns with gladness in your hearts as you pray to God for better times now. Today's Eucharist is about on the theme of the call of the disciples. And so in a moment of silence, let us call to mind those times when we have failed to heed God's call when it came. Let us confess our sins to Almighty God. Our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against each other, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people, and bestow your peace on our times. We ask this from Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was lying in the sanctuary of the Lord, where the ark of God was, when the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel," he answered, "Here I am." Then he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, since you called me." Eli said, "I did not call. Go back and lie down." So he went and lay down. Once again, the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, since you called me." He replied, "I did not call you, my son. Go back and lie down." Samuel had as yet no knowledge of the Lord and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. Once again, the Lord called. The third time, he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, since you called me." Eli then understood that it was the Lord who was calling the boy. And he said to Samuel, "Go and lie down. And if someone calls, say, 'Speak, Lord, your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord then came and stood by, calling as he had done before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, and let no word of his fall to the ground. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul's to the Corinthians, chapter 6, verses 13 to 15 and 17 to 20. The body is not meant for fornication. It is the Lord, and the Lord for the body. God, who raised up the Lord from the dead, will by his power raise us up too. You know, surely, that your bodies are members making up the body of Christ. Anyone who is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. Keep away from fornication. All the other sins are committed outside the body. But to fornicate is the sin against your own body. Your body, you know, is the temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you since you receive him from God. You are not your own property. You have been bought and paid for. That is why you should use your body for the glory of God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
As John stood with two of his disciples, Jesus passed, and John stared hard at him and said, "Look, there is the Lamb of God." Hearing this, the two disciples followed Jesus. Jesus turned round, saw them following, and said, "What do you want?" They answered, "Rabbi," which means teacher, "where do you live?" "Come and see," he replied. So they went and saw where he lived, and stayed with him the rest of that day. It was about the 10th hour. One of these two who became followers of Jesus after hearing what John had said was Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter. Early next morning, Andrew met his brother and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which means the Christ. And he took Simon to Jesus. Jesus looked hard at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas, meaning rock." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you,
may I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our readings today are talking very much about questions and answers, and certainly at this time, this year, we do have a lot of questions ourselves, and the answers seem to be different depending on who you listen to. But I want to focus this morning on the question that was asked of Jesus, and also about Samuel's question and answer. Jesus asks the two disciples, "What do you want? What do you want?" And they don't ask, "We want to know everything about you, Lord." They don't ask, "Will you read us the scriptures and explain them?" They don't ask, "What synagogue are you going to? What sect do you follow? What words do you use?" What they ask is, "Where do you live?" As I'm sure you're all aware, where do you live is a difficult question at this time, as we can't open our homes to others. But Jesus was able to bring them to where he did live, where he was himself, where they could learn more about him. Not about what he did in the synagogue, not about how many times he bowed his head, not about whether he used incense, so many things it wasn't about. It was about Jesus and how he lived his daily life. And that's something we, I think, need to take home with us into our homes. Because our daily life is full of choice, isn't it? It's the moment some of our choices have been taken away from us, but we still do have plenty of choice in life. This gospel speaks to us about how we live our lives. Not when we're in church, not when everyone can see us necessarily, but how we live our lives in the intimacy of our own homes. There is a lack of intimacy at the moment in society. We can be in a bubble, like I am with my mother-in-law. We may be on our own completely, but we do have choices nonetheless. We can decide to get in touch with somebody else. We can decide that we're going to spend this time praying for those we care for. Perhaps we're even writing letters. Even in lockdown, there are choices. But the disciples wanted to know what Jesus was like in his everyday life. That's where they chose to find him. That's where Jesus chose to show them who and what he was. But Samuel was already lying in the sanctuary of church. He was already in a holy place. But God asked him, "Where are you?" And surely that shows us that the intimacy of how we are at home and with our loved ones is something we carry everywhere. Certainly it was obvious where Samuel was. He was in the sanctuary. Perhaps this is more about us hearing God say, "Where are you?" and saying, "I'm here," whatever that may be, however difficult that is at the moment. During last week, my one remaining uncle died. And so as a family, we've been thinking about how we manage during this difficult time to have a funeral. My aunt, who is in a nursing home, has decided that she won't attend. And part of the reason she won't attend is because she is aware that she will not be able to hug and kiss and thank people in the way she would like to. So for her, remembering a man who she had known and loved for 47 years, we'll be seeing the hearse go past the window of her care home, and on the way back, her children are going to toot their horns. For someone who is an incredibly tactile woman, that is a difficult choice. But she does have choices, as do we all. Perhaps, like me, this third lockdown has really hit you. Certainly, I think I can be honest and say that my mental health has taken quite a dive this time. But the choice of where Jesus is for me, for my community and my family, is something I still search for. And we can all do that. Whether we're like Samuel, lying in the sanctuary, being in a holy place, like some of us are here, or whether we're like Jesus, being at home, where people can learn something about how we live, where we can learn about ourselves. I think, and I hope, that I'm not the only one who had great ideas for last year. Wonderful, all this free time, I'm going to do this, and this. I think I learned how to make carrot cake, and that was about it. So there was a bit of a silver lining. But actually, what we wish for, free time to do so many things, isn't necessarily what we need. Motivation is gone, anxiety takes place, uncertainty seems to be the bill of the day. But Jesus is with us at home. If asked now, where do you live, Rabbi? He would say, I live in the heart of all those who believe me and love me. I live in the places where life is difficult. I live in the places where choice is hard. I'm often asked, why did God allow this or that to happen? And my answer is, God gave us free will. God gave us choice. He also gave us imagination, resources, and intelligence. And it was up to us to choose how we use them. I'm very grateful for the scientists who chose to use their abilities to put together a vaccination program. My choice is that when I'm given the option, I will take the vaccination. Because not only will I be protecting myself, I'll be protecting those around me who I love. Some of those people may decide they don't want to take the vaccine. That's their choice. I choose to love and care and help healing. So as we go forward into a week of more uncertainty, let's hold Jesus with us, in our hearts, in our minds. Let's hold Jesus with us, in the home that we are, to the Holy Spirit. Amen. So we come to our responsorial creed. The response is, I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
I believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So we come to our intercessions. We'll be thinking about God encircling us where we are. Circle us, Lord. Circle our church with the light of the gospel. May we understand more of our faith and why we believe it. May we understand more of our doubt and not be too hard on it. May we commit ourselves to following you in the small details of our lives, in our homes, in our intimate relationships, in our relationships with those who are caring for us, and in this particular fellowship of St. Lawrence, and at this particular time. Circle us, Lord. Keep light within, keep darkness out. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Circle us, Lord. Circle our nation with the values of the gospel. Give to our national institutions, government, the law, the health service, the church. Give them the values of justice, fair representation, concern for the poor, and equal opportunities for every person. And may the sheer generosity of your presence infuse our national life with hope and encouragement. Circle us, Lord, keep hope within, keep despair out. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Circle us, Lord. Circle our family and friends with the love of the gospel. Keep them in peace and security. Guard those of our loved ones who are vulnerable. Strengthen those who are struggling. Encourage those who are on the brink of something new. May the deep peace of the Prince of Peace keep them all. Encircle us, Lord, keep love within, keep danger out. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Circle us, Lord. Circle the sick and the bereaved in your healing presence. There are some we know who are simply not well, some who are fearful and in pain, some who are on their last journey. Circle them now, Lord, the very people we name in our hearts or aloud. Circle them in the healing presence of Christ. In this moment, we remember those who have died recently. Martin Preston, Pat Pickstone, Vesta Williams, Doreen Sutton, Rennie Sims, and Douglas Jones. And also those whose anniversaries fall today. Charlotte Hilsdon and Joyce Jeffries. May the touch of Christ be for those who are sick and those who are grieving, the touch of wholeness and healing. Circle us, Lord, keep peace within, keep fear out. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Circle us, Lord, our hearts, our homes, our church, our nation and our world. Circle us and let us never slip outside the enchantment of your grace. For Jesus' sake. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. As best you can, let's share a sign of peace with each other.
Thank you.
Grant us so, Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of the sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. And so far, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our election. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom, all share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Lawrence and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence to the Father, in the words our Saviour gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall.
Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, may those who have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. A warm welcome to St. Lawrence again on this, the second Sunday in ordinary time. Not many notices this week. On Wednesday, we will continue with our 10:30 Eucharist, preceded by exposition of the Blessed Sacrament at 10. So the church will be open for private prayer on Wednesday morning, and the Eucharist will be celebrated at 10:30. Anybody wishes is very welcome. Last week, I think we had two people. It will be entirely safe, at least as safe as we can manage. So, come if you wish. On Thursday, we will have a meditation broadcast at 5 p.m. in the usual manner. So, you're very welcome to join us at 5 p.m. Thursday afternoon, or it will be available subsequently for catch-up on both Facebook and YouTube, so 5 p.m. onwards from Thursday. Next Sunday we'll be celebrating the Eucharist. It won't actually be a live stream next Sunday because I shall be away and my colleagues are all shielding or at other churches. So it will be a pre-recorded service, but it will be available from 10 o'clock next Sunday morning. And the following Sunday, we'll be back to live streaming at 10 o'clock. And the subsequent Sundays, hopefully, we shall be back in church altogether. But that depends upon the COVID figures going down and upon people being vaccinated and being able to come out of shielding. Let us pray for the moment when we can all be reunited back here at St. Lawrence's. On a personal note, could I just say a huge thank you to all those who supported me personally over the last week, following my mother's death 2 weeks ago today. Thank you for your emails, your cards, and for your phone calls of support. I do feel very surrounded by support by members of St. Lawrence's community, and I and Helen are very grateful at this time to you. Thank you. God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you. Go in the love and peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.